As I said before, it did not take long at all for Miku to become popular in Japan, and her popularity spread quickly to a worldwide audience thanks to sites like YouTube. Zero G looked at this and asked themselves why Miku became so popular when their own Vocaloids didn't, even though they had voice banks that were just as well made. Prima had been a moderate success for Zero G, as she was the first English Vocaloid to gain noteworthy appeal, but she was still completely overshadowed by the Krypton Vocaloids. So Zero G decided to experiment with their next Vocaloid. On July 14, 2009, Sonica was released. Sonica was a big departure from Zero G's previous Vocaloids in that she was not designed for the professional market. She was created to appeal to musicians who were already aware of the Vocaloid concept. Sonica was the first English-language Vocaloid to have a character created specifically for her, with a persona placed on her box and a short bio written on the back. But they went a lot further than that. At this point in time, the Japanese Vocaloids already had worldwide fans, and Sonica was intended to give those English-speaking fans something similar they could use. She was designed specifically for the Vocaloid fan market, meaning amateurs. This was both a good and bad experience for Zero G. Sonica was able to help bridge the gap between the Japanese and English markets by offering something familiar to both, a young girl with a versatile, youthful, energetic voice. The downside was that they were now marketing a Vocaloid to its toughest critics, and her lower quality voice bank, compared to the likes of Prima, had many flaws. Sonica was also the first Vocaloid to have an official comic created for her, which was placed on her product website, and perhaps even more interestingly, she has a Twitter account. Really? She made posts on her Twitter account, explained things going on in her life, what her likes and dislikes were, and sometimes responded to fans' questions or statements. There was a little bit of controversy around Sonika. In November 2009, Zero-G held a contest asking people to submit a new character design for her. But after the contest finished, Sonika's product page displayed a picture that was not from a contest entry. Zero-G had to explain that the winning entry was not necessarily going to be used on box art, and that the new box art image was drawn by an artist hired by Zero-G. With the success that companies like Krypton and Internet Co. were seeing with their Vocaloids, other Japanese companies took notice. One such company, AH Software, decided that they wanted to get into the Vocaloid franchise in a big way. So they partnered directly with Yamaha to release not one, not two, but three different Vocaloids on the same day, the first of these being called SFA2 Development Code Miki. Yeah, it's quite the name. Most people refer to her as SFA2 Miki, or simply as Miki. What does the SFA2 mean, anyway? Nobody knows. Miki is voiced by one Miss Furukawa Miki, who was the bassist for the band Supercars, now a solo singer. Miki's most striking point is her appearance. While the Krypton and Internet Co. Vocaloids are simply considered to be very human-like androids, Miki was specifically designed to look artificial, complete with doll joints. She was also designed to look very young, to allow her to fit into childlike roles if desired. As for her voice, she has one of the widest vocal ranges of the Vocaloid 2 generation, but her best performance comes from her low notes and her high notes, with her mid-range lacking the same power. This makes it difficult for artists to use her voice to climb octaves, as it must dip out of her peak notes to do so. The second Vocaloid in AH Software's December 4th lineup was Kai Yuki, the Vocaloid franchise's first child Vocaloid. Kai Yuki's voice provider was actually an anonymous primary school student. Yuki was designed to provide a Vocaloid which could sing children's songs and to be used for other kid-friendly venues. But despite being voiced by a very young singer, her voice bank produces realistic results and has a soft, soothing voice that is unique to the Vocaloid 2 era. She is also said to mimic English syllables better than the earlier Vocaloids. The final Vocaloid in the trio was Hiyama Kiyoteru. Kiyoteru is officially Yuki's school teacher of all things, and offers users a soft male voice bank with an amateurish feel. Unfortunately for Kiyoteru, he is the least popular of the AH Software Vocaloids, primarily because his voice is not very deep or masculine and can be difficult to tune in the lower ranges. The AH Software Vocaloids in general are some of the least popular, but Miki has had some success, and Yuki can be used to augment or provide backup for songs of other Vocaloids to good effect.
Thank たのは偽りのキス重ね合わせた肌のぬくもり一夜限りの魅惑の果実消えた記憶のかけらに眠る後悔の後失った過去夕立ちの中立ち尽くす君霞んでゆくダークネス閉じ込めた衝動解き放つ我が波ミストが来て打ち寄せる希望を鮮やかな絶望に変えてアンダーザダークネス駆け抜けるのも
AH Software released three Vocaloids on the same day in an effort to capitalize on the opportunity to give Vocaloid producers more options. Miki has a very large range, Yuki caters to the children's market, and Kyoteru offers an additional male voice bank. But here is a Vocaloid that was developed at the same time as Sweet Anne, but released almost 3 whole years after her. His name is Big Al, and he was released by Power FX, that wacky Swedish company, in December 2009. Big Al is interesting in several ways, not the least being that he actually had 2 different voice providers. During development, Big Al was voiced by one Michael King, a singer and award-winning Elvis impersonator. A few demos were released with King's version of Big Al, but Power FX was not completely satisfied with the recordings or the development of his software. When they tried to do a re-record, King was busy touring and was not available, so Big Al became the first Vocaloid to change voice providers in development. Power FX found Al's new voice very close to home in a former Power FX employee named Frank Sanderson. As far as performance, Big Al was designed to offer English Vocaloid users a rougher, harsher voice than Leon, the last male English Vocaloid voice bank. Yes, it took 5 years for another male English Vocaloid to be released. And when used properly, Big Al is pretty good. When Leon was introduced, he was used to sing some songs on an album called A Place in the Sun. But when that album was being created, the artists involved realized that Leon's voice was not husky or rough enough to sing some of the songs they wanted to do. It was from that complaint that Big Al's development was spurred. His intended genre is classic rock, but he has been used to do blues and jazz as well. He is considered one of the easiest of the Vocaloid 2 voice banks to use, but because of his rough voice, he doesn't do so well in the higher octaves. Still, he is a vast improvement over Leon, and comparisons of Leon and Big Al are very interesting to those wanting to learn more about the development of voice synthesis software in general.
Somehow, right here and now, I'm at my breaking point and it's all crashing down. Oh, you wouldn't understand, oh, just how I feel. I'm at my breaking point and I'm a burn it down. Will I get through this somehow, right here and now? I'm at my breaking point and it's all crashing down. Oh, you wouldn't understand, oh, just how I feel. I'm at my breaking point and I'm a burn it down. I'm laughing, I'm burning.
Too late. Love has got side effect. It can't be perfect, though it is real. A classic hackneyed, he said, she said, could have started more instead. I let my cigarette burn out. than what you are. And I'm learning my memory. I'm stuck on that code. December, December, oh yeah, I'm giving up. I can't tell what I still remember, remember. But if we were in love, we should have taken.
Look into my eyes and I'll hold you with the moon. Like Tiger, I've got the moon. Like Tiger, I've got the moon. Like Tiger, maybe it's hard when you feel like you're broken and tired. Nothing feels right, but when you're with me, I'll make you believe that I've got the key. Oh, so get in the car, we can ride it wherever you want. Get inside it and you want to steer, but I'm shifting gears, I'll take it from here.
Well, if you must care, and I come to you everywhere. I am a robot, a clockwork toy robot, and your love always makes me alive. I am a robot, a little tin toy robot. We have lived together for a long time. What I know about you is everything of you, and I know you are not so strong.
The last things to touch on about Big Al relate to his marketing and distribution. I know I said a couple of times now that the people at Power FX are a strange lot, and if you feel I'm being harsh, listen to this. I said in Sweet Anne's section that her box art was based on The Bride of Frankenstein, remember? You might have heard that and thought to yourself, yeah, sure, that sounds far-fetched. Well, look at this box art for Big Al. This was his original box art design when he was being developed with Michael King's voice, an Elvis Frankenstein's monster. Power FX's comment on this was that their English Vocaloids were intended to be cyborgs rather than androids the way the Japanese Vocaloids were. Big Al's later box art and character were designed by the person who drew the comics for Sonica's page. As for Big Al's distribution, there was a hiccup when he first went on sale. Power FX sold Big Al as a download on their website, but the hosting for the download was done through a separate company. That company must have done something wrong, because no one who purchased Big Al was able to download him at all. Power FX received complaints from both English and Japanese customers who were told by Power FX that they would make things right. They would make sure they got Big Al, even if they had to mail the customers a disc at their own expense. Those who pre-ordered Big Al also got a $50 gift certificate for other stuff on their site. Good for you, Power FX. That's customer service.